opportunity. It's exciting, isn't it?
It's really exciting. Yes, it is. And that's why I'm here. I wish all my teammates could be here as well. If they could, they would. Trust me. They had other obligations. And since I'm local, I was here for the support.
Yeah. He outlined the banner philosophy. He outlined it very well. Is that a big deal to you guys or not?
It's an ancillary subject topic. That is something that's in the back burner. If it comes up, which I think it will later on down the road, cool. Right now it's about Juwan Howard establishing himself as the head basketball coach in the program moving forward and continuing the success.
Did you see a coach in him when you played with him?
Absolutely. Like you said, he was always a coach on the floor. Juwan was the guy. Let's start with the recruiting, number one. Being recruited and going through the process as a 17, 18-year-old kid and having the wherewithal to deal with that emotionally yourself and then recruiting players after you make the decision to go to school, to recruit players to play with you, it speaks to his character. And with 30-plus years of experience in the NBA, it's even better now. So I'm looking forward to see what he could do in the next year.
What kind of coach will he be?
He's going to be an emotional coach, but I think it's a good balance with emotional with accountability. He's going to want the best for them. He's going to give them what they need. And like Ward said, the X's and O's, not worried about that. He's been, his record speaks for itself. I'm just interested to see how these young men continue to develop and be pillars in the community.
How soon did you talk to him after you heard about B-Line leaving and try to start selling him on coming back?
Immediately. I think that was something where, you know, it's a situation where, like Juwan said, everybody woke up, you know, that Monday morning with text messages shook from John B-Line leaving the program, and immediately, you know, you start running through a mental list whether you have one or not. And obviously, you know, my choice would be Juwan, but there were others, you know, like Ward alluded to, but setting aside that he played at Michigan, that he was a part of the Fab Five, his tenure in the NBA, his passion for this university, I think is going to lend for him to be successful here.
Were you one of those 20 text messages he got first thing that morning?
I was not. I think I was probably the 21st, but because at 6 in the morning, I'm still asleep.
What would it mean? I know I came in late. I'm sure you answered this question already, but to see those banners back up here, do you think there's a healing process that really accelerates with him taking this job?
Yes. And just like Jalen said on air the other day, we're not bringing any beef, any drama here, anything that would distract from Juwan doing his best job here. So immediately, it's over. There is nothing to bring here. And just like Ward said, hopefully this year the Fab Five will be here. I won't even say hopefully. We will be here this year.
You think you see that confidence about Chris as well?
We'll be here this year. Yeah.